We are an architecture studio that are focused on the well-being of astronauts and future space travelers. We believe that in the near future we'll see more and more civilians in space, and not just these super hardcore trained professional astronauts. LUNARK is a moon habitat for the near future of moon exploration that fits within a rocket, and then it lands on the surface of the moon and expands 750%. We wanted to create a habitat for future astronauts where they could thrive and not just survive. So we looked at the entire globe of Earth, and then we tried to find the very best place to simulate a moon mission. And we found that at the Arctic, at the North Pole. So the first big challenge that we had to face during this expedition and designing the habitat was figuring out how to make a structure that can fold and fit within a rocket. The second thing was, what is it that takes a habitat from a survival machine and makes it into a livable, pleasant home? We do both visualizations that are very hungry for a powerful graphics card, but then we also do heavy computation and simulation work that needs a powerful processor. We are lucky enough that we are existing in a time where accessibility to powerful computers and powerful software is within reach. So we can do things as a small studio here in Copenhagen that wouldn't have been possible just 10 years ago.
Making such a complex design as the habitat, you need to use quite complex 3D modeling tools to develop the structure. And the issue is, if you're working on a slow machine, it's laggy and you get a low frame rate, and that's just incredibly disruptive for the creative process. Working with a computer that's powerful enough that I'm not working at the speed it allows, but it's working at the speed that I want, is a game changer. So even though some of us were working on ThinkStations, Carl, who was the primary one designing the structure of the habitat, was actually doing all of the work from his ThinkPad. Just because it's mobile doesn't mean that it's slow or anything. It still has powerful components like the Intel Xeon CPU, and it still performed up to the task at hand.
Reliability in anything that has to do with outer space is super important. And that was the single most determining factor for choosing our laptops.
The battery life of the ThinkPad is also extremely important in this scenario. Everyone knows how batteries can behave in cold weather, and you have to keep in mind this is one of the coldest places on Earth. It can get down to minus 40 degrees, and it handled the temperatures extremely well.
We have learned a lot from the expedition, and we are using all of that knowledge to inform our next habitat design, which we're starting in a couple of months. We live in an exciting time where the chances of you and I going to outer space are greater than it has ever been. Imagine what the future looks like when you have access to these powerful workstations. It's going to be incredible.